What could it be? Warwick. I can't read that. Corvette series. Their silkscreen went all goofy. Oh, and it's this. And it's really doesn't play very well. It's got this fancy adjustable nut, which I have seen before, and they usually break. I'm told that one's been replaced because it already did break. I think what happens is people try to change that when there's string tension, and it doesn't work very well that way. And funky bridge design, which looks somewhat to be an ass pain. Potentially frozen bridge saddle screws. But most importantly, we need to straighten the neck, because it isn't. I'm not going to put new strings on it, but I'm going to pop the strings off it and give it a little cleanup. And fancy fret wire. Ooh, look at that. Give it a little cleanup and a setup, and hopefully these will turn. I'll put a little drop of Earl in those now. Yeah. Is this going to work? You can do it, Dave. Hope everybody's doing good. I got my new glasses. I can see. Well, this week anyway. We'll see what happens next week. Uh-oh. Spillage. Stopping. And it was working so well. Yeah, my eyes are working this week. See about next week. Still haven't heard about this freaky appointment. It's always good that they freak you out, right? It's always a good medical practice, you know, as a doctor, to freak you out and say, hey, you know what? This could really be a big problem. We're going to send you to somebody that's going to help you, and then you don't hear from them. Always my favorite. Okay, let's just let that creep in there for a bit. And for my next magic trick, which one do I want? Let's try this one. You can do it, Dave. From a previous episode, the old saved up cutoff string end. Clean all the gouge out of those screws. So what do we figure? Warwick? What is that? Germany? I'm pretty sure. I guess we're figuring it's Amatatic. Kind of interesting bridge. Does this whole thing go up and down too? I guess we'll find out. Oh my goodness, it's a communication of great importance. Stand by. No, it was not a communication of great importance, and it's really somebody I'm not interested in talking to right now. So the way this little guy works, right, it's got those set screws, and you can move it up and down to get the first string height. And look, it's got this little door. Let's prop it open and see what's inside.
Back to what I was saying. Wow. I'm saying 5 mil, I guess. Try it, see.
It's a weird looking hex configuration.
Like I said, sometimes you look at the outside of it, it's way bigger than the actual part that the wrench grabs way inside. So, that is 5 mil. I really want to try and straighten this out. Oh, and it's tight. Let's try loose first and see if this even turns. Ooh, a little bit of a crunch there. But it is freaking tight, boys. Give me a moment here. Well, I got it to turn. I'm just sort of trying to eyeball this straight before I even put a straight edge on it. But it's... this big hunk of wood of a neck. What I'm gonna do here is just a bit of mechanical help there. It's the weight of the body alone down there. I could clamp that too, or you can get your partner to help you. That looks a lot better, but that's with no strings on it. That'll have to suffice for now. A quick little wipe down, and I don't know, they give you this special wax or something to put on it, which is upstairs, which I guess I'll get, and we'll clean the goo off the frets.
So what happens with this bridge is that these two guys lock it down, and there's four that let you move the whole thing up and down, right? Plus you have the individual string height adjustments as well. So should be good. In fact, I'm not going to screw with the individual ones. I'm going to dunk this down because it wasn't. And now that I've straightened the neck, I probably won't have to disturb these very much if they were set properly in the first place.
Well, we're all tuned up. What happened? I don't know. There's like this. Is that supposed to be like that? Like, I feel a transition where the neck is made of three pieces, right? You got me. Oh, it still doesn't look very good. What went wrong? I know the thing was turning. Did it actually? Well, I know it did something, but did it do enough? Not even close. Not even remotely close. So let's loosen the strings off a little bit and go at that again. Okay, truss rod lottery time. Well, I'm turning it, but I don't think it's doing much. Yikes. I'll try again. I started on this today because I thought it was going to be the easy thing to do today. But unless I can get this neck to straighten out, I'm going to have to take it off the guitar and clamp it to the bench. Man, we're not getting there at all. So I'm back to doing what I was trying to do before. I got it clamped to the bench this time, and we're going to mechanically assist bending the neck in the direction we want it to go while I'm adjusting the truss rod. And this thing, if you hear that, it's turning, but it's just tight. And that's not the nut that's tight, that's the whole thing trying to move inside the channel that it's set into.
Well,
we're not really getting anywhere with that. It's moving. So, yeah, I gotta let Buddy know that there's the chance this might not ever play as nice as he'd like it. Can I really just lower the string action right now, like quickly while I'm looking at it? Does it just look so awful? Does the whole thing drop down, or is it, it's down to its bottom position there now? All right, yeah, and it's still awful, man. What has gone wrong here? All right, well, it's more than just a setup. I'm sort of almost getting to the point where I'm thinking the truss rod doesn't really work on this at all. Like, it's really not changing the neck straightness at all under string tension, unfortunately. So I'm eyeballing this, and I'm seeing a slight twist. So we end up with more than like 22 thou of relief. Markers. Yeah, even a little more than 22 thou of relief on the treble side. When we go over to the bass side, let's see, what do we add here? Yeah, way more, like 15 thou more relief on this side. So it's got a twist in it, guys. It's time to stop. I hate to be the guy that has to give out bad news, but today is going to be one of those days. The truss rod does not work, and the neck has a slight twist in it. But, hey, guys, look, it's a bolt-on. So maybe the Warwick guys will be able to solve your problem.
Unfortunately, I can't.
So with that being said, I'm signing off. It's time for a sandwich, because I can't do no more. The patient is pretty much comatose, and life support will only make it look good. All right, folks, thanks for hanging out. All the links to crazy stuff are down in the bottom, below me in the description. Subscribe, become a patron, join the Facebook group, get a Dave's World of Fun Stuff sticker, you know, all that good stuff. But anyway, most importantly, be good to each other. Cheers.